your back!
Drinking a toast to your force.
If we kill any more of the children of Adam, there could be war, Alan. Just stop this.
This ain't some innocent, Avery. This is a damn saboteur. Those condensers down by the freshwater. The storm didn't take them out. She did. Machete Mike spotted her.
But the children...
It's like I've been saying. The children of Adam are out to kill us all. This here saboteur meant to cut us off from food and water. Punishment is pretty clear, Captain.
Do what you must.
Yeah! Children bastards!
You were right, Alan.
Now will you listen to sense? The children of Adam need to be wiped clean off this island.
You've had your blood today. I can't stomach any more of it.
All of you, show's over. Go home.
I lost my home when the fog rolled in.
Thank you.
Hey, Doc.
Your patient, Andre. He's walking around. If I'm not too careful, there's gonna be two doctors in the harbor.
How's it going?
People around here have had a hard go of it. And manners on this island are a bit sparse in the best of times. And mainlanders tend to be a bit friendlier, all told. So I always enjoy the extra company.
I need some medical attention.
Then speak up. I'm listening.
Feeling sick. I think it's radiation.
Well, let's begin the treatment then. Done. Now, was there anything else bothering you?
I'm pretty beat up.
Let me take... Oh, that's not so bad. All done. Any other complaints?
Never mind. We're done.
What? Oh, you're leaving.
You need it? The bait shop's got it.
You give that fog crawler what for? Courtesy of the Daltons.
Grandpa George can rest in peace. The fog crawler is dead.
Wonderful. That's another chapter successfully concluded. You truly are the heroic Avenger I hoped you were. With that fog crawler gone, we can send some folks up there to get the place ready for you. That's right. The farm is yours. Your own little piece of the island. It'll take work to get it up and running again, but you'll have help. And here's another 200 caps in gratitude for your service to the great Dalton lineage.
Really, it's no trouble.
Well, I hope you know how much it means to me that Grandpa George can finally rest in peace. Now, I don't have to tell you that the bonds of blood and family are strong. As strong as any a person can know. But if you ask me, the strongest among them is the bond that exists between two married people. That's why the last part of this tale is the hardest one for me to tell.
You were married. What happened?
My late husband, Daniel, was the best fisherman this island ever saw. He and his crew had a favorite fishing spot out by Brooks Head Lighthouse. One day, a day I'll never forget, I see Danny's boat pulling up with his crewmen all shouting and carrying on. Turns out some trappers moved into the lighthouse, no doubt because the island told them to. They're all crazier than a bag of mole rats. Their leader was having a little target practice. Shot Danny right between the eyes. Killed him, just like that. You go and get that son of a bitch. You make him pay for doing the island's bidding.
How do I get to the Brooks Head Lighthouse?
It's southwest of town, not far from the quarry.
I'll make that trapper pay.
All right, then. Remember, trappers may be half crazy from the fog, but they still know how to use a gun.
That on. Have time.
If you need a room, see Mitch.
You look like you need an ice cold vim.
I could use a drink.
Let's get you liquored up then. Ha!
Hey.
What's eating you? I'll be happy to carry any spirits you got. Of course, I can't promise you'll get them back.
We're the only bar in town.
Life's too bloody short to be sober.
You know, when I'm feeling down, a little commerce always cheers me up.
Let's see what you have.
Happily.
Brooks.
Psst. Looking for a bargain?
Let's deal.
Happily.
Gun.
sober for this! Do you hear it? Does it speak to you?
Got it.
realize what a mistake you made.
Is this the fog?
I'd say it's time for a drink.
You're dead already. Go. No, man. I'll find ya.
Teach him. Better us get it than someone else.
Aim straight and true. What? Ain't you had enough yet?
Thank you.
hope you choke on your own blood, you bastard!
Can I have a word?
What do you want to talk about?
Look, I know I ain't the easiest man in Far Harbor to get along with. Social graces? Well, that's never been my strong suit. Thing is, most folk in Far Harbor ain't worth a damn anyway. All of them cowering behind their wall, too scared to fight for their home. Can't like someone I can't even respect. And, well... that brings me to you.
So, you're saying you respect me?
I ain't going soft on you now. Don't be thinking that. All I'm saying is, it's good to meet someone who can take care of themselves for a change. Hell, I ain't been close to a lot of folks in my life. And there's even fewer I'd call a friend, but who knows. We stick together long enough, Captain, and it might just be that you're my next one.
You sure about that? My friends tend to get into a lot of dangerous situations.
That's every day of my life. All right, enough of this blubbering. You lead and I'll follow. Seems to be working out so far.